situation for El Reno and OKC Metro. If you know someone, call them and tell them to take cover in El Reno as this storm is approaching. This is a large, likely long-track tornado. You know me, I don't get all crazy on you, all right? I want you to understand the severity of this situation, and that's why you've got to take shelter. Mark Fricklin is in this soup. Mark, what are you hearing?
We've got a semi that got blown over right here, Rick, right on I-40, and looks like the driver might be out trying to get some help here, but this is what happens when something like this crosses the road. I mean, he just blew that big old semi right over on the side.
He probably didn't even know it was coming, Mark. Because you look at Mark's screen, that's what it looks like right before the tornado hits because it's wrapped in rain. If you're in Calumet, that's what it's going to look like, okay? Let's again go back to Advantage Doppler HD. We want to track this. This is a very large tornado, very well-developed circulation. That's going to be passing very close to Calumet and El Reno. There's the truck that Mark said blew over. That's probably, you know, obviously very close to where it crossed I-40 because the storm is now north of I-40. I mean, look at the winds out there. It looks like a tropical storm blowing around. And in that mix, we have a large tornado. Mark, we see your shot. What are the winds like where you are? It looks pretty windy there.
Right now, the winds are very strong, and they're still flowing into the storm. That's the inflow you're seeing, and it's like hurricane. It's like being in a hurricane, basically. I mean, there's trees blown over. There's, you see the semi right here, and these guys are going into it here is probably not a good idea.
Okay, very good, Mark. Appreciate the info. And again, a result of some of the strong winds. Let's look at where that storm is again right now, and then we've got to look. We've got to go and look north at the storms there as well.